There's no easy solution, but as a football community, all you can do is just obviously highlight it, notice that and accept there is a problem, and there's got to be some rules set in place that clubs can take seriously, international teams can take seriously as well, the world can take seriously. Otherwise, it's not going to go away, and it's just going to get worse because people just think they can get away with it.
Did you say that stuff that you'd ignored as a player?
Yeah, when I was younger, I would ignore certain things, but I didn't get it as often as what's going on right now. I think Raheem's getting it a lot, and I don't think mine was that bad. Or maybe I was just I was turning a blind eye to it subconsciously. I don't know, but right now I just look at it saying there's a big problem right now, and the more we highlight it, it seems to be getting worse. I don't understand how that happens. It's supposed to go the other way, but there's a lot of work to be done, obviously. People are just doing it because it's in fashion, probably, as well, because people are that dumb that people do that. So, oh, I'll do it because he done it, and they got a bit of exposure. Even though they might not even be racist, they just do it just to get on the telly. You know what I mean? So these things are happening, and it needs to be squashed now.
They wouldn't say it to your face, though. You're a big lad. They must be saying it in this crowd,
you know? Oh, mate, if they said it to my face, it'll be a different problem, right? They'll say it in the crowd where there's 1,000 other people to drown it out.
Social media is different. You never had that, really, towards the end of your career, I suppose, right?
No, I didn't really have it that much, but look, when I was younger, I went to, where did I go? Me and Darren Bent, we got it hard I think it was under 21, and we got bananas thrown at us. And we're playing for England under 21s against Spain, it was.
In Spain, yeah.
Well, that was the first time I actually saw it on, and it was directed at me. But you know what? I kind of laughed it off when I shouldn't have. I should have taken it a bit more seriously, but I was just busy on the job I had in hand. We had to try and beat Spain. Yeah. We drew in the end, but I actually forgot about it. It was only Darren Bent brought it back to my attention again, and it was just one of those things. If I'd have taken it more seriously, maybe I could have helped earlier on and put a stop to it. But you know, I don't think you can. Like, every time you stop one person, there's another 4 that crops up, 5 that crops up. You know what I mean? So how do you stop it? It's really hard.
There's obviously been a lot of calls, like you mentioned earlier, for tougher sanctions. Points deduction, stadium closures. Do you think that those kinds of club-facing penalties are actually effective at curbing fan behaviour?
Yeah, of course, I think so, yeah, because points deduction, definitely. Points deduction. But then you're going to have people infiltrating it, pretending to be a fan and then say something in the crowd. And if it's on that, you know what I mean? There's so many loopholes that people can get away with it. So I don't know. But one thing I must say is that now it's not just black people talking about it, it's white people, it's Indian people, it's Asian people, it's everybody that's talking about it now. Like, and I think if it's just the black people, back in the day it was more of the black people just saying, I can't take this abuse, and it wasn't really getting heard. But now when you got a white fella saying it, people are saying, you know what, it's getting to that point now where it's affecting my teammate, and now your teammate's sticking up for you. And he's a white heritage, so it's better that way that someone else says it instead of the victim.
On a more positive note, obviously we're here tonight celebrating a charity that uses football to change lives. I'm curious if you can articulate in a positive sense why football does have that power to transform people's lives.
Listen, like, it's when you go to the World Cup. When you go to the World Cup, like, all the fans are together. You don't really get like brawls at a World Cup. You know what I mean? When you've got different countries mixing with each other in different pubs, everyone's got from different culture. And that just shows you how powerful football is. Like, fans from, like, say, Senegal will mix with fans from Croatia. Do you know what I mean? And no one, because you're going to watch a game of football, nobody really, there's not really any bad vibes. Everyone wants to actually be there and have fun together. And it's like a carnival sort of scenario. So everyone's always together and trying to make everybody come together as one, and that's in football, and that's what football does. It just brings everybody together.
You started your career at Chelsea. There's quite a few great young English players at Chelsea. Would you like to see them getting a little bit more game time?
Yeah, of course. I didn't get as much game time as I wanted. That's why I had to jet off to West Ham. And eventually I got into the England team that way. But yeah, they need to. I think Chelsea always have to take their youth seriously. I think the only person that's actually gone in and broke in properly was John Terry. Do you know what I mean? So that's a long time ago. Yeah. And now I'm looking at it, I think I got, 40-odd appearances or 39 appearances for the first team. And it's not enough. I think there's a lot of work to be done with that, because there's a load of homegrown players being shipped out and farmed out to other clubs. And I think they could actually look at their own, because we've got the talent.
What advice would you give to someone like Hudson-Odoi, who was obviously linked with a big move away to Bayern Munich in January?
Do you know what? It's anything that he feels to do, that's what he should be doing. I'm not saying that he should go to Germany, but when you look at the history, Jadon Sancho has gone there, done well. There's a load of players that can go elsewhere now and have the confidence and go to do well elsewhere. You don't have to be in the Premier League to forge a career. So anything he wants to do, he should do. And as long as it's not money driven.